When it comes to content creators, live streamers, YouTubers, Instagrammers, whatever, we don't often hear people talk about motion. Motion is such an important part that if you work in the film industry, you know that one of the best tips to add production value is to add motion. Good motion, motivated motion, if you will. A couple of months ago, I saw an ad for the DJI Osmos, I believe it's called. It has a face tracking capability, right? And I thought, oh my God, that's amazing. I would love to have something that adds motion, but also does it automatically. So I don't have to worry about it. I don't have to be controlling it. And I've been obsessed with this whole thing ever since. I even went on AliExpress and tried to find the cheapest face tracking motorized mount that I could possibly find. There will be a separate video on that, but this is not what we're talking about today. We're talking about something way better. When Edgy contacted me at first, I was like, well, I just bought this other cheap thing. What will I do with this? What's the difference? What is so special about this thing? And then they proceeded to tell me what was so special about it. There's so many things that are special about it. But right before we start, it's not an ad. I just want you to know that I started a brand new channel. It's a tech review channel. So my goal here is to finish all of the tech reviews that I have to do for this month. And then starting next month or for the rest of the year, I will be making my tech reviews exclusively on my tech channel. So check it out. There will be no more tech. I'm trying to do less tech reviews on this main channel. So this is the Edgy Follow, and it comes in a box. Well, actually, it came in two boxes for me. One containing the actual follow, and then one containing a ring light. Of course, you'll have a phone mount. Of course, it also comes with a ball head. It comes with a phone mount. It comes with your USB-C, because this charges in USB-C. And of course, the follow. So what sets the follow? I want to give it to you straight already, okay? This is not your typical face tracker. Why? Because, for example, this cheap face tracker works only with your phone. The motors are super weak. This cost me less than $10, less than 10 euros. The motors are weak on this one, and it requires you to download a very, very shady app that is like, the app is horrible. I can't wait to make an actual review on this one just to show you. But anyways, this does not require you to install or download or anything. This is the face tracker. It works without your phone. It works with anything. On their website, they even have a little video where they show someone put a fan on it. I could put the Streamer Brain mug, available link in the description, on it. Well, let me turn it on first. Wait for it to detect my face. Okay. This is shady. Move my head around. And as you can see, it's following me. I don't know if you can. So this is one of the major game changers when it comes to face tracking gear. This does not require your phone, so don't worry about the app. So you can use it with whatever. The other thing is the weight. This is 500 grams and it is solid. It's plastic, don't get me wrong, but it is solid, meaning that it actually supports your DSLR. Now, I don't know what's the maximum size. I will probably, if you guys want to see me test it, follow me on social media. I'll probably like put some heavy weights on it and see how much it can handle before it breaks. But yeah, I put my DSLR just like that. As you can see, there's the cold shoe mount there, and it handles it perfectly. No issues whatsoever. So those are the two main things, is that when it comes to the weight, it's not one of those flimsy phone ones. It's a pretty good, pretty solid phone, DSLR, fan, Streamer Brain mugs, all of that, you can use it. Okay, so let's talk about the unboxing, okay? Nothing special when it comes to the packaging or anything. Again, you get the follow, you get the USB-C cable, you get the ring light that comes with it. The ring light has a little three different color temperatures from it. So it's warm white, cold white, and then a mix in between. You can obviously check the brightness of it. It's not super, super bright. Definitely, we're not talking anything like the Elgato ring light that I'm using right now. Nothing close to that, but good enough. Also, it's pretty cool that they include that in the package. Although, if you go to their website, you'll see that the ring light stuff is like 10 bucks more. Talking about that, well, we'll get to the price later. We'll get to the price later, okay? It's not as... You're thinking it's super expensive. It's not. It's really not, which is amazing. Okay, so when you take up the follow, first of all, at the bottom, you'll see there's a quarter inch screw. So you can put that on any tripod, any mount, any camera mount that you already have, which is great. It charges with USB-C, which is awesome, but it also has that USB port up in here, right? What is that USB port for? You can charge your phone with this. You can charge. It has an internal battery, so when you charge it, you can use that USB cable to charge your phone. Or you can just use it to power the actual ring light. I think that's why they put it there. But hey, it can charge your phone. You can plug anything and power it with this. Amazing. If you already have a ring light that works with that, amazing. Now, the main mounting thing is a cold shoe mount. All right. It's that little T shape there. That's a cold shoe mount. I wish it wasn't. I wish it was a quarter inch thread because that's way more like it's more popular when it comes to like camera gear and stuff like that. But hey, they provide you with a ball head that has a cold shoe mount and then converts to a quarter inch thread. So you're fine. It's just that if you have a different ring light, it might be different. The ring light also has a cold shoe mount for you to put that same ball head that is included. So you can put your phone or the phone mount, which is different. I don't think they needed to have something different. For example, they could have used something like this that I own. This is not part of the pack. So it's a phone mount with a quarter inch thread. That's it. They could have just put that, but okay, it's fine. So how smooth is it? Now, it doesn't ramp up, okay? When it comes to what, I think it ramps up when it starts to move, but it doesn't slow down. You don't feel like it decreases in speed when it stops. It feels like the stop is pretty abrupt. So it's not super, super smooth. When it's moving, it is smooth, right? It doesn't shake, it doesn't do it. It's pretty stable, it's really stable actually when it moves. But when it's the stopping, that is pretty abrupt. But it doesn't move super fast, so it shouldn't be a huge issue. It's just that if you're trying to do very, very smooth cinematic shots with it, this is not what you should be using for that. The little camera, I'm guessing it's a camera. It's so tiny. I'm guessing it's a wide angle, but the angle is not too wide, meaning that, you know, if you move around, it starts moving pretty soon. It seems like the angle is kind of similar to what a front camera would have. So it stays with my Samsung Galaxy S20 FE. It was pretty accurate to what I was seeing on the front camera, which was my surprise. Because imagine if this is a camera and it's like a super wide angle and it has this fisheye view and everything. That means that when you move, wherever you move in the room, it would see you. This is not the case. This is actually, I would say, like cropped in a way that it resembles your phone, making it super intuitive to use because you can kind of tell, okay, I'm going out of frame now. As you can see on the sides here, this is kind of indented. I don't know if you can see that. See that? I don't know if that plays a part, but basically you can kind of tell if you're too much on the side and you're starting to get out of the frame. It's amazing. I am really, really, really pleased with this. I am surprised. I didn't know that existed because in the market right now, you either buy a camera that comes with an app or you buy, you know, the motor, the mount that comes with an app. The cheaper you pay, the shadier the app. Although those are the pros, right? Big pro. You don't need an app. It's not connected to your camera. It can track no matter what happens. Other pro, it's portable because you can charge it. You can even charge your phone with it, power your ring light with it. Oh, amazing pros right there. USB-C, it's getting more and more popular. That's a pro. Super simple to use, one single button. That's a pro. It is solid and can hold the weight of a full DSLR. That's a pro. What are the cons, you're wondering? When it stops, it's abrupt, so there's no scaling when it comes to the acceleration. There's no acceleration. It just goes and then it stops. I guess there's a tiny bit of... It's not that visible because it doesn't move super fast, but it would have been nice to see it very, like, try to smooth out the action a little bit. So it's not cinematic, but if you're using this for a video conference or for a live stream, it's completely fine. con, the main one that I can think of is the fact that since it only detects faces, you will see the LED is white and then it becomes green once it detects a face. It cannot do object tracking. That's a con. This thing right there can do object tracking. I have a gimbal that can do object tracking, but that is only because I'm using them through an app. That means that I can select an object on the app and it tries to, you know, compare the pixels and stuff like that. This only looks for faces, and once it found faces, it just tracks it. But you can't, there's no other function than what it's meant to do, basically, unfortunately. Now, let's not forget the biggest pro, I would say, is when they contacted me and when they sent it, when I tested it, I actually did not know how much it cost. So I was getting ready. When I realized how good it was, I was like, okay, how am I gonna justify like $150, right? It is not $150, because that's what I thought it was. It is currently on the website getedgy.com at $29.99. What? Just for the follow, that is, right? The ring light is separate and it's for $10.99. And it works. I'm surprised. I didn't know that was a thing. So far, I haven't seen anything that is compared to it, especially the fact that you don't need an app. And even though I owned a pretty expensive phone gimbal, I prefer this just because of how simple it is. Also, it looks good. I like the look of it. It's a pretty cute design, compact, pretty futuristic. One single button, one slot. It's great. Anyways, I'm gonna stop myself from geeking out too much. If you want to hear me geek out way more about tech in general, go check out Gale's Tech Review. That's my new tech channel. This is where I'm gonna be reviewing not only tech that are sent to me, but mostly the tech that I use, things that I buy personally. And if you would like me to test some stuff, if you have any questions, if you want me to answer some questions about this thing, I'm gonna keep it for sure because I love it. And get ready for the review of this one. This one was €7, I believe. And this only works with your phone via Bluetooth and stuff like that. So this is something that's gonna be posted on my other channel. I might make a follow-up after using it for a while too on the other channel. Go subscribe to Gale's Tech Review, okay? That's my point here. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you check top right, you will see what YouTube thinks is the next video you should watch. And then at the bottom, you will see my most recent video. Check it out. Also, stream review. check out the links in the description. And I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.